It's going. I'll wait and see if anybody pops up. Hope everybody had a good Thanksgiving. Made some stuff yesterday. Let's see. Did this one? Thought that was pretty cool. This one? Oh, I was trying to make a like a monster kind of growl. Oh, needs to be lower. Okay. Let's start over. Wait. Just creating an envelope here. Really long attack, really long decay, turning the sustain all the way down. Oh, I need to make this envelope. Make this short or long. This. Change this. Let's add oscillator B. Reset. Thank you. Why are you doing that? Sorry, apparently Ableton was coming through twice, so probably sounded crazy. Apologize. The heck?
Thank you.
Okay. Gonna record. No, freeze and flatten. Right now, let's do something else. Actually, I'm gonna add. So I have this app or plugin called Texture. And it basically allows you, it works as like an envelope follower, and it allows you to set a limit and a gate to the audio that's coming in, and then depending on that threshold and the gain coming in, you can, or amplitude, you can like add other sounds. So they have like their own sounds, so I could add like choral clusters. Let's see what that adds to it. I don't know if you can hear it. You can also add an envelope to it. You can change the pitch, you can change the timbre, I guess. There's like a modulation section. Oh, cool. All right. Let's do. Hey, if you're in here, say hey. I'm going to kind of just go about my business. I'll make this decay longer. I don't like how it's like choppy. I thought that the decay would be fine. The only thing I don't see is pan. So I guess I could sidechain this, or I could make this a separate track and control the panning myself. But that's unfortunate. So for now, just because I want to be able to control the panning, I'm just going to make this all the way wet. Freeze and flatten. And then now I only have. And then I can add like supermassive or any kind of like other effects to it. Let's just make it nice and wet. Okay. And then now I can control the pan. So I'm just going to make it go from left to right. Turn it down a bit. But yeah, it's a you can bring in your own stuff into that plugin, which is pretty cool. Hate this color. Let's make it like a soft yellow. What was the best thing that you had for Thanksgiving dinner or lunch or whatever? What was the best thing you ate for Thanksgiving? Mine was aside from my mom's pumpkin roll, some potato. It was like a cheesy sour cream diced potato bake with like grape nuts on the top, like as a crunch, which was like interesting, but like it was really good. We got lots of leftovers. I will probably have that when I take a break. Let's just use the noise oscillator and let's bring something in from my library. If you didn't know you can do this, you can bring in your own noise oscillator in Serum, which is pretty cool. Pretty quiet. You can also, so if you turn this on, you can pitch it. So I could modulate the pitch. Not that fast. Modulate the panning. I'm really bad at like the whole Facebook birthday wishes thing. Let's do some weird stuff. Noise. Let's. What the heck was going on? Yeah, I don't really like that. Let's try. Right now. That's cool. Let me save it. It feels like haunting. Haunted cave drips. That's what we'll call that one. Well, if you're just joining or if you're watching and you don't know what the hell I'm doing, I am making I'm just doing like ambient stuff from scratch, just trying to practice like doing this stuff without and when I say from scratch, sometimes it's synthesized, but sometimes it's also like things that I've recorded. So just like I'll take raw recordings, like I just took this one. Which was like a thunder tube that I have that I just put in front of a mic and messed around with. And then I put it into Serum and just did some effects processing to it. So let's see. And I'm gonna try to do this like every day, like at least, like an hour or something. What's up, General? Yeah, I made a little thing in Serum. So I started yesterday, or not yesterday, the other day, trying to. I'm just gonna try to make, just practice sound design from scratch. So I've been saving some things. Like I made this one yesterday. And then. This one I just did. I just took like a thunder tube recording that I made and put it in the noise oscillator and then did a bunch of effects processing. What else have I done? This one was fun. Whoop. Do it really low. It sounds like a crocodile. So yeah, I'm just trying to get my my library full of cool sounds, and I'm thinking about making a Patreon that basically I'll just save all my VODs to and offer like all of the sound stuff for free, or for whatever subscription it would be. Anyways. Yep. This is what I've got. Anyways, let's do something else. Let's get back into serum. I basically use serum for everything. I'm just comfy with it. Let's use an oscillator. Do you tune the crap out of it? Marzipan, you okay? Okay, and then whoops. Let's see, like, do some exponential rhythm stuff again. No, let's do, something fast. And then so I'm gonna modulate the rate of this LFO. This way. And let's make this more interesting. Let's do the cutoff. Know what? Let's do it with this guy. Hey, yeah, there we go. Yeah. Oh, hey. It's not what I wanted to do. Let's do it this way.
Okay.
Yeah, I need to save it. Save this as exponential. Drippy drops. I don't know. Oh, hey, thanks, man. Sorry, I didn't see everything. Do you use a handheld mic to record your sounds? I have, like, several things. So I have this, you're probably not even on anymore. Maybe you are. I have a shotgun, this Rode NTG1, or NTG something. I have a couple, like Audio Technica 2040s, maybe. And then I have some like various like small diaphragm condensers. I have one of my favorites is the Sterling, I think it's discontinued, is the Sterling P. Audio P 131, I think. I don't think that's right. Oh, it is. So I think it's SP 150 maybe now. Yeah. It's either the ST-131 or the SP-150. Either way, it was like $100 and it sounds awesome. So, if anybody's listening and you want to get a cool, cheap microphone, because it covers like the, I think it's 20 hertz to 20K. And it's crystal clear. I haven't had any issues with it yet. And then I also have a, this guy, the, H4N Pro, I bought this separately, this guy, but this is really nice. And you have like two XLRs that you can add. It's got phantom power. It's battery powered, so like you have to change batteries, but I don't use it a whole lot, but I haven't had to change the batteries yet. I don't leave it for like long periods of time, but I have set it up and kind of left it from time to time. And I haven't had any issues with the battery life yet. If you're sitting and like listening over and over again to your stuff or monitoring or whatever, that might change it. But it has like a line in so you can monitor. There's even like a remote thing. It takes just regular SD cards. Yeah, I've got one in there now. You can change the record level, and the built-in microphones are actually pretty good. I typically don't even put, you know, external mics in it, but, you know, you could put the, shotgun or anything. I also have a, I don't have it around. I have a contact mic that's a, it's a called a Marshmello, and it's like a high gain contact mic. It's got its own preamp inside. It's pretty cool. I've done some sound design stuff with that. I want to get a, oh well, I had a like an aquaphone, I guess you would call it, which is like an underwater contact mic or like a, I don't know, you can record sounds underwater. I never got any, I never had any luck with it, and then my dog ate it, so was basically a contact mic with it's like not hot glue, but some sort of like silicone coating on it. She ate the coating. I actually really like this. I think, but no. Yeah, I want to take this guy. I like making like knocks. I call them knocks, like reverb type knocky sounds. So if I just did like, I don't know if shimmer would work the best for this. Yeah. So you could like, I could take the size down and this. Ooh. I'm just gonna record that sampling. And then I can put them together. Oh, shoot. Turn this off. And you can just fade that in. I don't. And New York. This on there too. And then I'm going to put more shimmer on that. And then do this single reverse. Dark. Yeah, I don't really like that, but Innovate is not going to be competing this season. Unfortunately. We could not get. I mean, we couldn't get people to show up, basically. I mean, I could play you some stuff, I guess. I mean, because I did have about 3 minutes of the show written. And I think I'm going to finish it eventually, but yeah, I've kind of put that on hold and trying to regroup and reassess and figure out what to do next. Let's EQ this real quick. And I'll put Supermassive lightly on it. Okay, hold on. Why not? Right. gonna resample this real quick. Cool. Okay, yeah, just for you, Justin, let's see. Innovate 2023. Okay, yeah, just for you. Nobody else is watching anyways. So I'll tell you a little bit about it. So it was called You and Whose Army, and it was basically it was going to be like a green screen floor, white props, white uniforms. It was all going to be like very minimalistic, and it was going to be centered around a central character that is playing a typewriter. And there was going to be a contact mic on the typewriter. And so the typewriter was going to be like an instrument and a texture throughout the show. But basically, it's like about the creative process. And so they are typing up their manifesto throughout the show. And so there are four people on the corners that are like in these, they're like really like, kind of creepy. They were going to be in like robes and have these like plague masks on, and they were basically going to be kind of like the establishment, like kind of the theme of the show was don't tell me what to do. So a lot of what we were doing in the show was going to be like based on that idea, like we're going to do things that like you don't want us to do. So the whole first minute of the show is only typewriter and like this Radiohead. Well, I sampled it, so I didn't actually take it from the Radiohead tune, but it's Fitter Happier, and that's sampled, and it's all choreography. So it was like no instruments, no melodic content at all. And then it breaks into Steve Reich sextet, and it's like 2:10 or something, and then it's and it was going to be like six mallets because of the way the piano part works. It's like three notes in one hand and three notes in the other hand, and it just goes back and forth. So it was going to be like just an easy six mallet like block chord kind of thing. And then it's like cymbal feature, bass feature. I kind of like go backwards a little bit. So I did a cymbal feature first. And then there's like a bass feature. The first thing that the snares and quads do, they just play like ping shots at, pianissimo, and they run across the floor. And there was this thing that I figured out that you can do with your feet, and they were going to be doing that. And so we were trying to make it like as creative and different as possible. But yeah, here it is. This is all I had.
Fitter, happier, more productive, comfortable, not drinking too much, regular exercise at the gym 3 days a week, getting on better with your associate employee contemporaries, at ease, Eat ye well, no more microwave dinners and saturated fats. A patient, better driver. A safer car, baby smiling in backseat. Sleeping well, no bad dreams. No paranoia. Careful to all animals, never washing spiders down the plug hole. Keep in contact with old friends, enjoy a drink now and then. We'll frequently check Reddit at model bang, hole in the wall.
That whole thing at the end, well, not at the end, but there's like this section that's like sounds random. So that's the snares and quads playing like ghosted triplets at 210, but they're only playing like random rhythms. And the typewriter player was going to be actually a snare drummer from Fourth Wall last year. Like, he's got some chops. But he also is like a terrific performer. I was going to give him like basically a part. And it was going to be like a lot of like just syncopated stuff that goes along with, you know, whatever the battery's doing or the rest of the ensemble. So the idea was to try to create like the sort of like natural rhythm of a typewriter, which is like sounds random, but it, you know, we tried to meter it out. So but yeah, it's unfortunate. I mean, it'll probably never be seen on a WGI floor, but you know, we've considered maybe doing something else with it, maybe doing like a short film or something. Or, you know, I could always just like finish it and put it in my back pocket and save it for later or sell it to someone. I don't really know. I don't really think obviously no one's interested in buying or using my stuff for winter. Seeing as I literally can't get a job to save my life. I've been broke for like 2 months. So I'm just trying to keep myself busy now. And hopefully Vanguard will start soon and a lot of other stuff. marching band sound design gigs can't start too soon for me right now. I need it. The plucky bass. I think it was literally just like a plucked string bass. I think I might have done some like processing to it. But it was just, are you talking about the boom, 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 boom? Come on. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Yeah, it was just, I think I used, if I can remember, it was, I typically use, like, Spitfire, like, one of the Albion things, and just, like, a, it was just, like, a pizzicato string bass. It might have been mixed with, cello as well, but I probably just EQ'd it and put I use Saturn and Volcano and like here. Sometimes I use Saturn more than I use actual EQs because it's so awesome. Yeah, without, with, yeah, I love Saturn. It's like one of my favorite plugins. It's like the best saturator I've ever used. I don't know, like, other people seem to be doing fine. I've always struggled finding jobs, man. I'm such a recluse, like, I just stay at home and do my own thing. I don't go out and socialize and stuff, so I think people just forget I exist most of the time. So, maybe if I just live stream and put my face all over the internet, then people will remember that I exist and I do things. Maybe it's worth a shot, right? What is going on? I do like Pro R. It's a very interesting, I tend to use the damn cat. I think they just broke something. I'm gonna have to go check that out. I tend to use Valhalla stuff like Supermassive, Delay, Shimmer, that kind of stuff more than I do anything else. But Pro R is awesome. I actually got that last, so I've only had that for like a month. Stop. No, you're not going in there. All right, I got a BRB. Thank you. I'm back. Anyways, yeah, Saturn's awesome. The cat knocked over a glass bowl. I had to clean it up. So my neighbor drives this electric SUV. And I think I've figured out what it is, but every time they pull up, it sounds like they're listening to just like this one long choir sample. And it just sounds, I mean, I will try to recreate it. It sounds like, it just sounds like, wait, oh. Like, that's what it sounds like. Like, maybe mute it a little bit. Like, if I were to take, like, an EQ. Like, and that sound is constant until they turn the engine off. And that's, like, the electric engine, I guess. And that's, like, what it sounds like. It's really wild. It's, you would think it's really faint, but it's not. Like, when I'm standing outside my front door and they're like, you know, 50 yards away or something, like, it's pretty loud. I don't know if it's supposed to sound like that, but it's pretty wild. Well, let's do something else. Really want to let's freeze this. I just realized nobody can hear me speaking. Okay, so let's do Supermassive. No, let's do Shimmer. Oh, no. Do Pro R. Then I can really tweak this. So I'm going to group this and then duplicate the chain, get rid of this one, and we'll call this one dry and this one wet. And character, And then wasn't really looking to do anything like melodic, but actually, Okay, I know that I'm not supposed to. But I'm just gonna throw. Okay, I'm probably gonna stop here for the night. Come back tomorrow. But yeah, here's what I did. Oh my gosh, why is no one saying anything? I've been doing all this crap and no one's I guess no one's watching, so it doesn't matter. But yeah, I've done all this stuff and nobody's gonna hear it, so whatever. So yeah, hey, what's up, Cam? How you doing, man? Are you on Twitch? Facebook? Where are you watching from? I will be, hold on. Oh, you're good. I'm streaming to all three. Like, you don't have to be any certain place. Kind of like not super worried about the whole Twitch thing anymore. 'Cause I don't really see myself being like a big streamer, but I do think that if I can, you know, spread my, I don't know, expand my reach a little bit, it might help whatever I'm trying to do, whatever that is. I don't know what that is right now. But yeah, I've spent a couple hours just doing some sound design, messing around. I did all this stuff from scratch, except for the strings at the end. All this stuff was mostly just serum messing around. But I'm gonna try to do this every day a little bit. And maybe eventually, like, host all my VODs on, like, a Patreon. And then have, like, subscriptions to, like, get all of the files and stuff that I'm doing. I don't know. It's just an idea. Because I'm broke and I don't know how to make money doing what I do. So I'm gonna try it. But yeah. It's cool to have you on. I don't know how to notify everybody the way I want to, but I'll be on pretty much every day. So I'll catch you on here another time. Later.